Hello everyone, I'm FARMERSIM and welcome back to Aghalee Farm. I do hope you're doing very well and having a lovely day. So I'd like to start by saying a massive thank you to all of you for leaving your comments in the last episode regarding my little idea of selling the forage harvester, the header obviously with the forage harvester and the silage trailer that we recently purchased. I'm glad you're all on board with that idea. I do think it could turn out to be quite good. Now, I have been doing my sums, and it seems like it is going to work out quite well. Obviously, I'll be able to sell all that equipment and get ourselves relatively debt-free. Not 100%. I could go 100% debt-free, but if I just carefully do things, it will afford us the opportunity to expand in a couple of little areas just to improve a bit of workings and daily life on the farm. So, going through a few numbers with you initially. Now these numbers regarding selling the equipment, this is all based on selling the equipment at the dealership. As we all know, you get a little bit more money for selling stuff at the dealership than you do just getting rid of them out of the in-game menus. So the forage harvester would be worth £385,038. The header for the forage harvester, £17,755, and the silage trailer, the Richard Weston, £19,679. So, including the balance that we currently have, the bank is currently sat at £56,471. That would bring us to a grand total of £478,943. So that's good. The outstanding balance on the bigger, we've got two loans. One of them is the big one that I recently got to purchase that big plot of land with the two fields. The balance on that loan is currently £296,192. The other loan has a balance of somewhere around 70 grand at the minute. But paying off the big loan would save us north of £4,000 a month, which is primarily what I'm intending to try and do. So if we go forward with that, that would leave us in pretty good stead. I have found myself a forage wagon, a pickup trailer. Now, one thing that did cross my mind while I was planning all this before having done anything is that I know that our tractors that we have on the farm, the most powerful one is this one, the Vulture, at 145 horsepower. Pickup wagons tend to be quite power hungry, I think. There's a few of them that only require maybe 80, 90, 100-odd horsepower. But for ones with a half-decent capacity, they require kind of 150 and upwards. So I suddenly had a bit of a panic thinking, oh, goodness me, yeah, you know, this plan I've got of buying a forage wagon, it's all good and proper, but what if I can only find one that's quite small and a bit pitiful kind of thing? But as it turns out, I've had a good peruse through the mod hub, and I found an absolutely ideal one. It's a Klaas-branded one. It's only £28,000. It only requires, I think, 90 horsepower, so it's absolutely perfect for the Vulture here. And it's got a pretty decent capacity off the top of my head. I haven't actually written it down, but I think it's just north of 30,000 litres. So that's pretty good. So we're going to be going forward with that. But the plans that do come with this whole idea and selling and making money and paying off loans and such, one of the things that I am acutely aware of regarding what we have on the farm is we've got our biogas plant obviously working away for us, but we're kind of hitting a bottleneck now. We've got more silage than the biogas plant can handle, as we are with manure. We are currently sat here, just 27,000 litres of manure. And we've only got space in the current biogas plant for not much of that. Silage-wise, it's still almost at the top. We've got a bunker half full of silage around here. Just going to wander around and have a quick check. But yeah, we've got... this is pretty much onwards from the last episode. We've got half a bunker here of silage that we can... It'd be nice to get loaded into here, but it just doesn't work fast enough for us. We do have this bunker here, which has currently 394,047 litres in it. Now, I did have a plan. There you go, there in the top right there. I've compacted it 100%, 394,047, so that's good. I did have a plan of keeping this as it is for now and adding to it. But this is where my plan moving forward with the money that we make from selling this equipment is going to come in. So for now, boom, I'm going to blanket this one. Because what I'd like to do, using the money that we have left over after settling most of our debts, I'm going to place down another biogas plant and another bunker. Because obviously we're working almost entirely with silage. Yes, we've got a couple of arable crops. We've got the canola. We've got some wheat over in those two fields over there. But predominantly, we're working with grass. Hopefully, in not too much time, this bunker will be empty. But I think it would be a good idea to have another bunker ready and available if need be. And also the biogas plant. Now, I'm not just going to place down any old biogas plant that you get base game wise or anything like that, because they are big things. They take up a big footprint of land. But what I kind of had in mind was one of the mods that I have installed. It's the biogas plant by Disturb Simulations. It's the one that I'm using over on my Court Farm series. And it's a really, really cool bit of kit, and it's quite small and compact. It's not particularly expensive. The one that I have, I have fettled with the XML, so the numbers are slightly different than the one that you'd ordinarily download. But it's not silly, if that makes any sense. I haven't increased the revenue that it gains. I haven't told it to make us more money per unit of methane or electricity or anything like that. I've just increased the capacities of it, and I've increased the work rate of it, cycles per month. So it just works a little bit faster. So with that in mind, what I think I'm going to plan on do is, we've got this field here. Now, this is always in my mind, with it being the smallest field that we own, I've always had this in my mind as moving into the future. If I ever had plans on adding to the farm, this would be what I always term as my sacrificial field. So what I'm going to do is place this lovely little compact biogas plant down somewhere around here, so that it looks like it's part of this biogas plant. If that makes any sense, it'll just look like an extension of the current biogas plant. And also, I'm going to place down another silage bunker, and I'm going to place that down somewhere over here. But I'm not going to do that yet, because I'd like to get all the grass out of this field and make some use of it. Now, what I think I'm going to do with this field is mow it up, row it, and bale it up into grass, and have it stashed in the bale shed over there as grass bales for the sheep. Because I think we've only got about 7 or 8 grass bales over there, so we could do with stocking up on them. They don't go through food too quickly, so just an extra stockpile of grass I think would be extremely beneficial. So that's kind of the loose plan that I've got going forward with all this. Doing what we're going to do, paying off, selling the equipment, paying off the debt. That's going to roughly leave us with about 150 grand in the bank, which is pretty good, if you ask me. That's before spending money on the biogas plant and the bunker. The biogas plant is about 55 grand, if I remember correctly. So, I suppose when we're finished with it, we'll have less than 100 grand. I think the bunker that I'm looking to place down is either 10 or 15 grand. I think it's 15, actually. So, yeah, that's kind of the plan. So, in order to move forward with that plan, we need to get this equipment over to the shop. So let's start with this behemoth. I am very grateful that you're all on board with this idea. As much as I do love working with the forage harvester, I think for the purposes of the farm, for the sake of moving forward and having a bit more money in the bank, we can still perform the same tasks, getting the grass picked up out the field. Because at the end of the day, you finish off with the same result, don't you? Whether you use a forage harvester or whether you use a pickup wagon, it's all going to end up in the bunker and turned into silage. So I may as well do it on the cheap. So off to the shop. Let's go increase that bank balance temporarily. Right, let's tuck this nice and close into here, because the footprint of the sell point here is quite small, but let's disconnect that, shift that out of the way. Last thing I want to do is go and accidentally sell my tractor. Let's turn that off. Now the point is usually about here. There we go. So there we go. I'm not going to repaint it for 8,500 now. So 385,000. That's gone down. It was 385,038 not long ago. It's now 385,004. Anyway, never mind. So we'll sell that. There we go. Thank you very much. 17,753. Yep. And 19,677. Boom. Balance £478,905. So, excellent. Right. So, next thing we're going to do is we're going to purchase our new forage trailer. So, let's go straight into that. Now, I have only just found it. I've just had a bit of a search on the mod hub, and I found this lovely thing. Because if you see what I mean, obviously we've got this lovely, this base game thing, the Boss Alpine Pottinger thing, 30,500. But they're quite small, aren't they? The next one up from here needs 95 horsepower, 23,000 litres. This was the one I was going to be considering at 130 horsepower, because the next one up, the Schwietmaker Rapide, requires 150. We're set at 145. So this was going to be the next option from base game stuff anyway. But it's just over 70 grand, so it's a huge amount of money. Going forward as well, I haven't got many mods in here for forage wagons, but I found that one there, but that's 150 horsepower. 250 for that big beast, obviously. And I've got the class cargo mod here, 105 grand, 240 horsepower. But here, the Klaas Quantum 3800K, £28,000. It requires 90 horsepower and it has a capacity of 35,000 litres. So that's absolutely bob on, if you ask me. It seems relatively compact. It's got that foldable top to it, so when you obviously activate it, you need to unfold it. It gets a bit bigger. We'll keep it in the Klaas colours for now. Boom. There we go. That's good stuff. So let's get this connected up, get back to the farm, and then I think we'll give the bank manager a ring and put a smile on his face, shall we? There we go. If you see what I mean, we can unfold that and it becomes a normal size forage harvester, I suppose. So it is. It should be quite nice and compact, I hope. I hope I don't live to regret this decision and find it doesn't work somehow or doesn't operate properly, but time will tell. So, as I say, back to the farm, give the bank a ring, pay off some loan, and we'll get cracking with the afternoon's work. Well, we've certainly got a bit more space in here now, haven't we? I'll no doubt fill it with something at some point. So, we're back at the farm. We have our new pickup wagon here. Lovely stuff. Now, the plan with this second biogas plant, it's essentially, in my mind at the minute anyway, it's going to act as a bit of an overspill biogas plant, just initially. We will obviously be keeping the big biogas plant topped up there, but as I said before, because of its cycles per month and because it doesn't go through stuff as fast as we can produce it, the idea is once that's full, we can then, as it is right now, for example, it's if I go into the production systems menu very quickly, just to show you what I mean. So silage-wise, it's completely full. I topped that up at the end of the last episode. Now, we are pretty much where we left off at the end of the last episode. I appreciate that, so not much time has passed. But it's still full. Slowly, manure. I suppose we can get a bit more manure in there. But I can't alter the XML for that biogas plant, or I don't believe I can. I have tried. I've gone into the map, because it's part of the map. I've gone into the XMLs for the map, but I can't seem to be able to see how to just amend the cycles per month for that particular biogas plant. So I'll just leave that. I don't want to mess anything up. So yeah, the idea is we'll place that biogas plant down here around the back, and when the big biogas plant is full, as it ordinarily mostly is, we can then put, for example, this manure in there. We can put this silage that we've got in the bunker here. Almost all of that can go in, plus a bit of the slurry. Now it will probably spend more of its time empty than it will full, because it's got a faster cycles per month. It will burn through the stuff quicker, but it will give us a decent hourly income while it's running, and that's where the justification for it came. Because it'll, you know, at 55 grand to purchase the thing, I can't see it being particularly long, maybe a few in-game months before it's paid for itself and we start to profit from it. So with that in mind, I think it could be a wise decision. Now, obviously, if I don't pay off the second loan, if I go into very quickly into the loan page, as you can see there, there's the big one and there's a small one, but that'll be costing us 2,300 quid a month, as opposed to combined, what's that, 4, 5, 6, it's just north of 7 grand a month, isn't it? So we'll be saving, or I suppose it's just shy of 5 grand a month that we'll be saving, isn't it? 4,707. So that's good. So anyway, let's go back into here. So special redemption. Let's do that, Mr. Bank Manager. 2,961,192. Yep. Boom. Done. We've paid off our loan. Excellent stuff. So our bank account is now sat at £154,713. Excellent. So we're now in the position I wanted to be, where we can now crack on with a bit of field work. We're going to get this grass mowed. We're going to get it rowed. We're going to get it baled up as grass, like I said before, and get it stashed into the bale shed as a backlog of grass for the sheep. So, let's stop talking about it, shall we? Right, there we go, job done. Nicely done. So we got 16 bales off that field, 3,500 litres of bale, 56,000 litres of grass. So that should keep the sheep sorted for a little while. That'll bring our bale count for grass anyway up to 24 bales, I think it is, 23, 24. So that's excellent. Right, can I squeeze in here? There we go. So, all that's left for me to do now is jump in the telehandler, pick up the trailer, of course, and get the bale fork onto the telehandler and shift them all into the shed. Right, here's the last of them. We almost had 17 bales as well. The baler was 95, 96% full when we'd finished, which was... I mean, it is what it is, isn't it? But we were almost there. But that's all good. There we go. Let's get that safety strap on there before I go cause any more damage, knock anything off or anything. So let's go and get these loaded into the shed. We'll maybe stick one or two in front of the sheep pen there, just top them up, because the sheep pen does gradually take from the bale, so it's very helpful that. So we'll go crack on with that. And then I think we're going to jump into the construction menu. and spend a bit more money again. See you shortly. Right, last two now. There we go. Got a nice little stash going on in the shed there now for the sheep. Moving forward into the near future anyway. We're always going to have the opportunity to grab a few more when we need them. We've got plenty of grass, haven't we? Brakes aren't too good on this thing, are they? There we go. So let's drop that in there. There we go. We just saw the food visually rise a bit there, so they should be fully stocked up. So, what do I need to do with this? I think, right, what I need to do with this is go and equip the bucket onto the front, because if everything goes to plan, we're going to jump into the construction menu, place down a new bunker, a new BGA, and then what I can do from there... Oh, goodness me. Right, brakes. There we go. Drop that off. Yeah, we can load in most of the silage that we've got there, and a bit of the manure as well, and get that starting to earn for us. Goodness me. Hello. Hello. Yeah, that was my fault, to be fair. Should have taken into account that this thing does not stop, clearly. Right, anyway. Let's get back round there. Get doing some building. Right, let's do this. So, construction menu, where are we going? Production, factories. Now, this is the one I'm talking about. The mini biogas plant by Disturbed Simulations. Both of them are the same price, 55 grand. This one offers a refueling option, which is pretty much, I think the only difference there is it has an electric vehicle charging point, I think. I think that's the only difference. So, just in case we ever decide to go green in the future, we shall use that one. As you can see there on the very end, on the right-hand side of it, next to the blue dome on the ground there, you've got the green refueling point. Oh, it does have a refuel point there as well, doesn't it? Let me just check. Yeah, forgive me. No, it's not just electricity that it refuels with it. I think it is fuel as well, isn't it? So if you look on that grey plinth next to the, in the centre of it there, under the auger pipe, there you've got a fuel... Yeah, we'll go for the fuel recharge station as well. Why not? Why not? So I'm going to leave the field as it is now, in its mode state, just because it'll help me to see the landscape around the building that I place and what remains and disappears as field. I'm kind of getting used to the idea that I might this field might just be completely binned off now. Obviously, when I place this down somewhere over here and I place a bunker down somewhere over there, the shape of it's going to be a bit awkward. The size of it's going to be obviously considerably smaller, and I need to paint in a bit of a road and an access point for the vehicles and stuff. So the field is going to get pretty small. So once we've placed this and I'm happy with it, I might just paint over the whole field again just with some grass, and essentially just forget about it in that respect. But anyway, let's get into this bit. So I think the bit I had, the placement of it that I had in mind was somewhere around here, so that it is close enough to the original BGA there, so that from the outside it will kind of look like it's part of the same setup. So there doesn't seem to be too much land alteration that's going to happen there. I hope it's not going to encroach into that field there. But if I kind of think about placing it there, 3, 2, 1. 55 grand, so that'll take us to 100 grand. Boom. Right. Okay. Ooh, very slightly. Very slightly, and that's not even my field. Sorry, neighbouring farmer. But we'll sort this out. We will rectify this and paint it in and make it look right in a few minutes. But that kind of looks... Well, when the landscaping painting has been done around it, that kind of looks like it's meant to be, doesn't it? And then over here, let's go to... silos. If we go along, I don't know where are we? It's further along here. There it is. That's the one I'm looking for. From the Bavarian Farm Pack by Bernie SCS. It just looks... I've always loved that kind of build up around the walls of it. It looks kind of cool. And if we ever get any overspill through the walls of the bunker, I think that kind of hides it, doesn't it? And I'm sure we're all aware that it's a bit frustrating, isn't it? But I believe it's down to the fill plane. But the fact that you can only orient your bunkers one in four ways, but it is what it is. What can you say? So I kind of had in my mind that we'd have this placed somewhere down here-ish like that, maybe. So let's... I mean, here's as good as any, isn't it? There we go. Boom. So we now have a third bunker and a second biogas plant. So let's jump quickly into the landscaping menu. And what we shall do is paint around it with the grass. That's how I always like to do things. We paint around it with the grass as much as possible. And then paint in the lane after that to try and make it look like it's been here for a while. So I've never been a fan of just having a plain old concrete floor placed down. So let's see if we can just grab that bit there. Yeah. Okay. Now that bit in between those two original domes of the biogas plant there, I think that is meant to be concrete, so we'll keep that as concrete for now. What's that? Okie dokie. Now, for now, if I just paint in or paint away some of this field, let's just bring it round in a smooth enough radius if we can there. Bring that to about there. There we are. Then cover all this. I'm only doing it like this for now, just so I can see, get a rough idea of what's left of the field that would be considered usable, if at all, if that makes any sense. So we'll paint away all of that. There's that. Excellent stuff. Right, so that's that, and that's that. Now here, again, I think if we were to bring this round here, trying to make it look natural, just follow it all the way round to about there. Yeah, that'll do, I think, for now. So let's get that bit covered up, and this bit all around the front. Now I'm going to paint in some kind of lane turning circle patch in front of the bunker here, because I'm going to wire it up to the auto drive network, so hopefully in the future when we get working in the fields, auto drive can come and self unload into here. So that's that. Now we want some plants. Let's get to that. This is one of my favorite parts of the game, you know, guys, just sitting here for, and I have done this for hours in the past, just getting my creative on. Now don't get me wrong, I've got no idea if it looks any good or anything like that, but just the fact that every farm's different, every layout is different, and I just love getting creative and trying to make it look as natural as like it's meant to be there as much as possible. And what I always tend to do is I'll paint everything over in grass first, like this, and then paint the lane in, so that... again, so it looks like it's been there for a long time. So let's just run that round there like that. There we go, there we go, there we go. We'll do the same over here. And so yeah, I'll do the same like this over here with the buildings, and then if I feel it necessary to paint in a little bit of tarmac or concrete around the edge of the building, having it all as grass first will just help again to make it look like it's been there for a while. So bring that round there, bring that round there, all the grass there, that should do us there, I reckon, roughly. And we'll do the same around the back. Now we're never going to be coming around the back here at all, are we? So there's that bit in the middle there, there and there. There, that's not too bad, I don't think. So now, if we go into, what have we got there? It's asphalt, we've got animal mud, asphalt, dirt, and gravel. I think we'll go for the asphalt. Select the circle again, and then we will just go back over a couple of bits here and just make a little area in the front, just so that it kind of looks natural-ish. There we go. Give it a little path around the back. Okay, that'll do there for now, I reckon. Have we got enough room there for a lane? Possibly. What's the size on that there? So that size there. Yeah, we could have there. So now, what I will do is then go into... Is that the dirt? Is that the dirt texture that I've done here? Yeah, it is. Right, okay. So I'll keep the same width as this lane here. And we will run a lane. So we'll start it here. Figure out where it's going to join up from there. But that looks like it's a perfect width. Yeah, there we go. That's worked, I think. And in order to give a bit of it, hopefully a bit of room to turn around in, we'll then paint all this round like that. And bring it back round into here. Now, I don't know if that's going to work yet for auto drive. It should do, I think. Time will tell. I don't quite like that jaggy edge there. That doesn't do... doesn't do anything for the OCD, but yeah, that I think might work. And then if we do the same, we're going to make a bit of a big patch here in front of the bunker. Now this doesn't need to be a particularly neat shape, it just needs to be an area that allows for the movement of the tractor. So if a tractor comes in, let's say he's going to be coming in from there, he'll kind of come in to there and then kind of turn around here. So we kind of make this big area here, get rid of all that grass. There we go, get rid of that bit there. That might be enough room. And that's completely the wrong texture, isn't it, you Burke? What have I done there? Oh dear me, silly boy. But we will texture a load of stuff in there just using some of the paint texture tool things there, just to again make it look weathered and old. So that comes around there all the way around. Don't need to be too neat with it. There we go, that'll do, I think. And then this bit can just kind of join up with that, kind of. There we go, roughly. Yeah, quite happy with that, to be honest, I think. Now we will, I'll do a lot more fine-tuning to it. We'll pop some grass verge down the middle and make it look right, but that should work for auto-drive, I think. Obviously, with us having small tractors and relatively small equipment, that should work. But I think what I should do now is get it loaded up with what we've got over there, a bit of the silage and a bit of the manure. So I shall crack on with that, spend a few more minutes in the construction menu, and I'll see you when it's finished. Right then, there we go, job done, fully loaded up with what we had. So jumping very quickly into the production systems menu, we now have two BGAs there. There we go. Now interestingly, it doesn't actually show the total capacity here. The same mod over on Court Farms has it tells you the quantity that you've got in there, and then the total quantity that it can hold. Now this will hold 5 million liters of everything here, but it, for some reason it doesn't display it. But either way, I have loaded up the bunker that we had uncovered and half emptied. It is now been completely emptied into here. We've got 183,126 liters of silage, just over 18,000 of slurry, and 20,000 of manure. The other BGA over here is, for all intents and purposes, completely full. I put I tipped it full of manure and a little bit of slurry, got that completely sorted. We've got 38,700 litres of digestate going away in there. Now, obviously, another bonus from this one is obviously we'll get more digestate in here as it ticks away. So hopefully into the probably distant future, we may well end up, at least once anyway, having enough digestate to naturally fertilise some of our fields. So that'll be good. But not a bad episode, I don't think so. We've essentially finished off the episode with more money, less debt, and technically a bigger farm. So that can't be too bad, can it? Quite chuffed with that. I've had to spend a few more minutes as well, just adding a little bit more detail into the decoration of the lanes here. Just a bit of a grass central verge there. A few variants on and the painting textures, as it were, just to make it look a little bit older. But there we go. So, and as you can see, this field is miserably small now, really, isn't it? So I really don't know what I'm going to do with it. I think I might just, as I said before, I think I might just paint over it and just call it that. And then at least then I know that we've got space in the future for any expansion we might need. If not that I can't think of anything at the minute, but you never know, if I suddenly decide we want another shed or, you know, the score. I've got room to maneuver, as it were, on the map. So, all good. So now the biogas plant kind of, I quite like the way it looks, to be honest, the way that the new biogas plant sits nice and close and kind of makes it look like one big biogas plant. Really quite happy with that. So, I think for today's episode, ladies and gentlemen, we've progressed. We have moved forward, onwards and upwards, as it were. Really quite happy with it. So, thank you very much for watching. I really do hope you've enjoyed the video, everyone. Thank you very much for your time. As always, if you're new to my channel, you like my content, and you like the way I'm doing things, please consider hitting that subscribe button and jumping on board, joining the channel. Please give the video a like, a thumbs up if you can. It does do wonders for the channel. It helps the YouTube algorithm do its thing. And as always, there are a host of links in the video description below with my Giants Partner promo code. If any of you are in the market for purchasing a DLC, an add-on, a season pass, or even the full game itself, and you like the idea of helping a content creator out at the same time, as always, I would be hugely appreciative. So thanks again for your time, everyone. Take care, and I'll see you in the next video.